Yes, students, today our chapter, next chapter is the measures of capacity. So that is nothing but volume. So before what we learn, so we learn measures of weight and measures of length. So how to measure length, how to measure weight. So these two concepts we discuss in our previous chapters. So what are the units of length? So what are the units of weight to measure? Okay. So length units are meters, centimeters, millimeters and kilometers, and weight units are grams, kilograms, that we discuss in our previous chapters. And how to add so weight units, then how to subtract weight units, and the same way the length units also, how to add and how to subtract, and also how to convert, how to convert. So these all concepts we discuss in our previous chapters. So that is the measures of length as well as the measures of weight. So in this chapter, what we are going to discuss? See here, so this is the capacity. So capacity means volume. So how to measure volume? How to measure volume? Volume is nothing but capacity. So what is actually volume? Volume means, so whatever the container, whatever the bottle, whatever, so how much the object holds. So that is the capacity. That is the capacity of that particular object. Okay, one container is there. So in that container, suppose 50 liters of milk is there. So then that is the capacity of that container. So that is nothing but that is the volume of that container. So capacity means nothing but volume. Both are same. Okay, here, so in this chapter, what concepts we are going to discuss? What concepts we are going to discuss? See here, total four concepts we are going to discuss. The first concept is the capacity or volume. So definition. First we are going to discuss about the definition. What is capacity means? That means volume. Volume or capacity, both are same. So the definitions we are going to discuss. Okay. The second concept, units of measuring capacity. So what units, what type of units, so we are using to measure capacity, that means volume. Okay, units, so like in mass means in weight, so kgs, grams, in the length kilometer, meter. So in the same way, so what are the units we are using to measure capacity? Okay, so that is nothing but volume also. Then the third concept, here the relation between the liters and milliliters. Liters and milliliters, basically we are using liters and milliliters to measure volume or capacity. Okay, liters and milliliters we are using. Okay, so then we are going to find the relation between liters and milliliters. 1 liter is equal to how many milliliters? That relation we are going to discuss in third concept. In the fourth concept, what we are going to discuss? Addition. So addition as well as subtraction. So these concepts we are going to discuss in this chapter. Okay, how many concepts? 1, 2, 3, 4. Four concepts we are going to discuss in this chapter. Okay, now in the recap exercise, in review exercise, so before means in second class what we learn, so that first we review, so through our exercise. First definitions, so these three definitions about volume as well as or otherwise capacity also. So first the definition, so the definition of capacity or volume. So what is the definition of a capacity or volume? See here the definition, the quantity of liquid in a container is the capacity, in a container or in a jug or in a bottle. So how much capacity, how much maximum capacity it is having, so that is nothing but that is the capacity of that particular container or that particular object or that particular bottle or that particular jug, whatever. Okay, so that is the quantity, how much quantity is there, how much quantity it holds, how much quantity, maximum quantity of liquid it can hold, it can have. So that is the volume, that is the volume of that particular object. Okay, so that is only the volume, means capacity. Next, in this example, a juice pack of 200 ml. So suppose one juice pack is there, so it's having 200 ml. So it means the capacity of that juice pack is 200 ml. So that is the volume, 200 ml, whatever the representation is there, the back of that or juice pack, so that represents the capacity. How much capacity of the juice is there inside in the pack? 200 ml. 200 ml juice is there inside the pack. It means the capacity of that pack is 200 ml. Okay. Now, capacity, second one. The capacity of the container tells us how much liquid it can hold. Here, container. Suppose so and so container is there. How much liquid is there in that container? So that represents capacity. How much liquid it can hold? It can hold. Here the capacity of juice pack is given 200 ml. Okay. So that is the 200 ml. What it represents? It represents. So how much juice is there inside the pack? That is the volume. That is the volume. Okay. Now, the third one, the standard units capacities. Capacity standard units are units denoted with liters. That is small l. L means liters. So liters are the standard units. Liters are the standard units we are using to measure the capacity of a liquid. Capacity of liquid. So in all this chapter, we are going to discuss about liquids only. Liquids only. Liquids capacity. Liquids capacity in a container. In a container, in a bottle, or in a jug, or in any object, how much liquid it can hold. That is the volume of that container. Okay. So what it represents? Maximum capacity. It represents the volume of that container. The volume of that container. Okay. Now see students, in this recap exercise, in review exercise, some word problems are given. So what is the first word problem? First read this one. So Vanshika bought 700 ml. ml means milliliters. Milliliters of oil. So 700 milliliters of oil. She used 250 milliliters of oil for frying. So total how much oil she bought? 700 milliliters of oil she bought. So in that 250 ml of oil she used for frying. So then how much oil was left? Whenever left is given, then so what to do? So we should subtract. Total how much oil she bought? So that is 750 ml. In that 250 milliliters of oil she used. Then how much oil left? In the total how much she bought? So in that how much she used, that we have to subtract. Then you will get total how much oil is left. Okay. Solution. Steps first. Oil. Oil she bought. Quantity of oil she bought. That is 750 ml. So this much oil she bought. Okay. Then oil she used. How much oil she used? 250 milliliters. 250 milliliters she used. Then how much oil is left? Here he is asking. So that means subtract. This is ones place, this is tens place, and this is hundreds place. First we have to subtract this ones place. 0 minus 0 is 0. 5 minus 5, same number minus same number is 0. Then 7 minus 2. 7 minus 2 means from 3 to 7 we have to count. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. It is 5. So 500 ml. This much oil is left. Oil left. 500 ml oil left. Okay. Next question. Next question. Mukesh bought 25 liters of white paint. How much? 25 liters of white paint. So this much he bought. Then and also 32 liters of red paint. L means liters. 32 liters of red paint for painting doors and windows. Then how much paint did he buy in total? Total he is asking. Total means we have to add. So white paint quantity is given 22 liters and red paint quantity is given 32 liters. This much oil, this much paint she bought, he bought, Mukesh, okay. Then total oil we need. Total oil means we should add white paint quantity and red paint quantity. Then you will get total quantity of the paint, okay. Now here. White paint quantity. White paint quantity, how much? 25 liters. 25 liters. Then red paint quantity. How much quantity? 32 liters. 32 liters. Now total quantity of paint means total paint how much he buys. Total means addition. 5 plus 2, 7. 2 plus 3, 5. 57 liters of paint he buys. Who? Mukesh. Okay. Now the next question, see here. So at the petrol pump, Ashok bought 20 liters of petrol. How much? 20 liters of petrol and 13 liters. In that, 13 liters of petrol was consumed, means used. So in total 20 liters of petrol. So how much he bought? Ashok bought 20 liters of petrol. In that 20 liters, 13 liters of petrol was consumed. Then how much petrol was left? Left, whenever left is there, then what to do? Subtract. So in total how much petrol he bought? So from that how much he consumed, so that we have to subtract. So then whatever the answer, so that shows how much petrol left. How much petrol left. Now here in the solution steps, petrol Ashok bought. How much? 20 liters of petrol. Petrol consumed. How much petrol consumed? 13 liters of petrol consumed. And then how much petrol left? So petrol left means subtract. Subtract. Now, so this is the minuend, this is the subtihend. Minuend is lesser than the subtihend, then take borrow from the next place, next digit. If you take borrow from the next place, next digit, then it will decrease by 1 and it will increase by 10. Then 10 minus 3 means from 4 to 10 we have to count. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. It is 7. 1 minus 1, 0, no need to take. 7 liters of petrol left. Okay. The next question. A milkman sold 35 liters of milk on Tuesday. How much? 35 liters of milk on Tuesday. And after that, 47 liters of milk on Wednesday. Okay. Then how much milk did he sell in 2 days? In 2 days total, how much milk he sells? Means total milk he is asking, how much he sells. So that means we have to add. Okay. First, milk sold on Tuesday. How much milk sold on Tuesday? 35 liters. 35 liters. So then second, milk sold on Wednesday. How much milk sold? 47 liters. 47 liters. Then total milk he sold. Total milk sold in 2 days. In 2 days, total how much milk he sold? So that means we have to add. Okay. 7 plus 5. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 means 2. Once 1 we have to take carry over on 10th place. Now 3 plus 1, 4, 4 plus 4, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It is 8. 82 liters. 82 liters of milk he sold in 2 days. Okay. That is on Tuesday and Wednesday. In these 2 days, total 82 liters of milk he sold. Now students, see here. So capacity and volume. Already we discussed. So what is the definition? What is the definition of a volume or capacity? So what is the definition? So we measure the quantity of various liquids such as petrol, juice, milk, whatever liquid, water, whatever liquid. So that liquid, the capacity of a liquid, so that is nothing but, so the capacity of a liquid, so we can measure in liters, milliliters, liters and milliliters. So the quantity, whatever the quantity, so that liquid is a juice or otherwise a milk or petrol or water, what may be it is. So we measure the quantity of various liquids, so like petrol, diesel and juice, milk, water. So thus the quantity of a liquid that vessel can hold, how much quantity of a liquid a container holds. So that is nothing but the volume of that particular container or particular vessel or particular bottle or particular object. Okay. Object, so and so object is there. If so and so object holds 1 liter of a diesel, so that means the capacity of that particular object is 1 liter. Okay. If one water tank is there, so in that water tank, so that water tank, if the water tank hold 500 liters of water, so then the capacity of that water tank is 500 liters. Okay. If a big container is there, so petrol container is there, so in that container, if 5000 liters of a petrol it can hold, that means the capacity of that container, petrol container, is equal to 5000 liters. So whatever the object it holds, so that is the capacity of that object. That is nothing but our volume. What is the maximum, quantity of a liquid particular object contains? That is the volume of that object. Okay. That is the volume of that particular object. See here. So this is a particular object. If suppose if half liter water, if this container holds, the maximum half liter water it can holds. So we can put in this object. That means the volume of this object is 500 ml. 500 half liter means 500 ml. So whatever the capacity of the object it can hold, so that is the capacity of that particular object. Okay. Now this is about volume or capacity. Then standard units also we discuss. So what are the standard units to measure volume? So that is liter. Standard units are liter, so we can represent as small l means liter. Okay. And in this milliliters also there, milliliters are the smaller units to measure the volume or capacity. So small l is the standard units to measure the capacity of a liquid, and milliliters are the smallest units to measure the capacity or volume. okay, this is about definition. So capacity or volume definition, and the second standard units. So in which units, so we are going to measure liquids. So then milliliters are the smallest units to measure the capacity or volume of a liquid. Okay, now the next concept, the relation between liters and milliliters. Here the relation between liters and milliliters, what is the relation between liters and milliliter here? So in a liter, 1 liter is always equal to 1000 milliliters. So this is the relation between liters and milliliters, liters and milliliters. 1000 milliliters make 1 liter. It means 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliters. Now here in example, 7 liters is given. So then, so convert into milliliters is asking. So how to convert liters into milliliters? Whenever liters are given, so then how to convert into milliliters? So liters we have to multiply with 1000. Liters quantity, so we have to multiply with 1000, then you will get in milliliters. Why? Because 1 liter is equal to 1000 milliliters. So that is why here 7 liters means this liters we have to multiply with 1000. 7 into 1000. If you multiply liters with 1000, then you will get milliliters. ml. ml means milliliters. 7 into 1000, 7000. 7000 milliliters. 7 liters means 7000 milliliters. 1000 we have to multiply with 7. 7 liters we have to multiply with 1000, then you will get in milliliters. Here in the second, 5 liters 550 milliliters. Then how to convert this 5 liters and 550 milliliters into complete milliliters? See here, this is our liters part. So this liters part, wherever we have liters, that we have to multiply with 1000. It means here we have 5 liters. So 5 we have to multiply with 1000. 5 into 1000. 5 we should multiply with 1000. And the remaining we have to add milliliters, 550 milliliters. The remaining milliliters after multiplying with 1000, these liters, the milliliters we have to add. Then 5 into 1000, 5000 plus 550 milliliters. 5000 plus 550, 5550 milliliters. So this is our conversion, liters and milliliters. Now students, see here, see in exercise first, convert the following into milliliters. Here in the first question, liter and milliliter combination is given. In the second one, only liters given. So then how to convert? Liters and milliliters are given, then completely in milliliters how to convert? See here, so in example we did. So here 8 liters are given. So that liter part we have to multiply with 1000, because 1 liter is equal to 1000 ml. So that is why we should multiply with 1000. 8 we should multiply with 1000. 8 into 1000 plus the remaining milliliters we have to add, 250 total in milliliters. 8 into 1000, 8000 plus 250 milliliters. So 8000 plus 250 milliliters. Okay, so this is in milliliters. The next question, 9 liters given. So liters we should multiply with 1000, then you will get in milliliters. 9 liters means 9 into 1000 milliliters. 9 into 1000 9000 milliliters. That's it. Here these are milliliters, these are milliliters. The total we have to add, then you will get total milliliters. Then here 9 liters means 9 into 1000, 9000 milliliters. Okay, now, so this is the conversion of liters into milliliters. Here, milliliters given in the second question, so then we should convert into liters. Then how to convert? See here. So this is ones, tens, hundred and thousand. Wherever thousand place is there, so that we have to take in liters. 3 liters and remaining in milliliters, 580 milliliters. Thousands place we take in liters, the remaining all the places in milliliters. Here, ones, tens, hundred and thousand. This is our thousands place. 5 is in thousands place, means 5 liters. 0 to 0 means 20. So take 20 ml, enough. Don't take 0 to 0. 0 have no value, so 20 milliliters, enough. Okay. This is the conversion of liters, milliliters, liters, complete milliliters into liters and milliliters. Okay. Now, the next concept, addition and subtraction of volumes. How to add, how to add, how to subtract. In example, so 3 examples are given. So I am going to do 2 examples problems in addition and 2 example problems in subtraction. Okay. Then here these 2 are addition sums, then how to add. See here liters and milliliters, here also liters and milliliters. So liters and milliliters given, first we add milliliters part, milliliters part. So then see here, 5 plus 0 is 5, extreme right digit we have to add, that is milliliters. 7 plus 5 7 8 9 10 11 12 12 means 2 in 10s place, 1 we have to take carry over on hundreds place of milliliters. Then 2 plus 1 3 3 plus 1 4, this milliliters completed. Then 9 9 plus 7 9 plus 7 9 10 11 12 13 14 15 16 16 16 liters, 425 milliliters. This is our answer. Okay. Now here also extreme right digit in milliliters, first we have to add. Then 3 plus 3, that is 6. 7 plus 7, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 7 plus 7, 14. 14 means 4 in tens place, 1 we have to take carry over on hundreds place of milliliters. Now 2 plus 1, 3, 3 plus 1, 4. 4. This milliliter part is over. Now we have to add liters. 9 plus 2, 9, 10, 11. 11 means, so 1 in 1's place of liters and 1 more 1, we have to take carry over on 10's place of liter. Now, 8 plus 1, 9, 9 plus 1, 10. 101 liter, 446 milliliter. Okay? Now, this is addition part. In the addition part, first we start our addition from extreme right digit of a milliliter. From right to left we have to add. Now in milliliters, how to subtract? These 2 sums based on subtraction. Then minus. 0 minus 0 is 0. 5 minus 0. 5 minuend is bigger than the subtrahend. 5 minus 0 is 5. 2 minus 1. Minuend is bigger. 2. 2 minus 1 is 1. This is milliliters part over. Now, liters, extreme right digit in liters. So, minuend is 0 and subtrahend is 7. Minuend is lesser, means we have to take borrow from here. So, it will decrease by 1. So, it will increase by 10. 10 minus 7. 10 minus 7 means from 8 to 10 we have to count. 8, 9, 10. It is 3. Then here we have 0. 3 liters. 150 milliliters. This is first subtraction in example. Here, the extreme right digit we have to subtract in the second. That is 0 minus 0 is 0. 1 minus 5, we cannot minus. So, this is the, so what is this? This is the minuend. Minuend is lesser than this subtrahend. we should take borrow from here. Here also 0. So it means we have to take borrow from the ones place of liter. So take borrow from here. So here 4 is there, it will decrease by 1. It will increase by 10. And again we should take borrow from here to here. So 10 it will decrease by 1 means 9. It will increase by 10. 10 means 10 plus 1, 11. 11 minus 5 means from 6 to 11 we have to count. 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. It is 6. 9 minus 2 means 3 to 9 we have to count. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. It is 7. 760 milliliters part over. Now, liters in liters ones place. 3 minus 1. 3 minus 1 is 2. Again here also 3 minus 1, that is also 2. 22 liters, 560 milliliters. Okay, this is about liters and milliliters. This is the subtraction. In example, more 1-1 question is there in addition and subtraction. That 1-1 question you do as your home assignment.